Hey guys, we're here today filming the operating room, an athletic male gladiator makeover. This is a great case of someone that's already fit. We're gonna sculpt out his six pack, give him a V taper, define his chest, and we're gonna use fat for his chest, his buttock, and his penis. So stay tuned today on Instagram and Snap to see an amazing transformation. We're also gonna remove his male breast glands, also known as gynecomastia surgery. So make sure you watch our plastic surgeon do an amazing job today. Hey guys, it's Dr. Emmer, and I'm really excited because very rarely lately do we have young guys that are just athletic and fit and want to get a more cut and sculpted look. Most of my patients are coming in for revision surgery, so we're here in the operating room today doing a primary case of a young guy that just wants a more athletic look. We're gonna sculpt out his six pack. We're gonna use some of the fat to build up his chest. And if we have any extra, his buttock, his penis, and part of his face, we're gonna use that fat to get a more athletic look, a more sculpted look, and something that's more defined. I'm really excited because when you can see the muscle already, you can really go in there and define everything out. Within a few months, he's gonna have a really defined body, but within one day, you'll be able to see it all. So come take a look. Stay straight. All right, we're gonna just start marking. And we first will mark the anatomy. Sorry if it's ticklish. We're gonna mark all the borders of the muscles here so that we can get the definition that we're looking for. One of the things we're gonna do today, which is really important in younger guys, is removing any breast tissue that's around the nipple. We're not gonna, in this case, do any lifting. We don't need to, but we're gonna do some gland removal, which will make it less puffy and more defined. The other thing that's really important is identifying, squeeze your stomach as hard as you can, his ab musculature, because we want to get it really defined. So what we're going to do is go in and define out exactly where. Good. Relax a second. Now squeeze. We're going to find out exactly where his ab muscles are. So first step is going to be to measure everything out and mark it. Relax. Do that again. Great. And so you can see he already has a lot of muscular definition. And so by going around the muscle, we're gonna really be able to get the exact look that he wants, which is to be more defined. And the key is going to be to define his natural anatomy. We wanna make sure that his anatomy is very natural looking, so it doesn't look fake. Ooh. A lot of people don't define the borders of the chest. With him, we're gonna keep him a little more rounded because that's the look that he likes. Some guys like a little bit straighter, but we're gonna get it to be tighter through here, which is why we're defining, we're marking here in blue so we can get it a little bit more tight along the edges of the abs. And again, defining out the serratus muscles. Okay, I want you to again crunch down. Double checking his ab shape is to make sure we get these folds to be a lot tighter. And we're gonna get rid of this back fat here. I'd like to give him some of the venous dimples so you could see here in his back. bend forward just a little bit. Just want to see you guys. So what we do is we're gonna mark his buttock in case we have enough fat. Just put a little bit in there at the top and middle. Guys, we have it a little more horizontal, a little less rounded at the top. So what would be good is get rid of all the flank fat. So we just did some great markings for our gladiator makeover, our young athletic male. We're gonna give him a six pack, a more defined look onto his chest, and use some fat to lift his upper chest so he has a more sculpted look, a better V taper, tighter skin, and if we have enough fat, that soccer butt look where we have the dimples in the back and lifting into the buttock, it's gonna be great. The next step is when you take fat, you can sometimes use fat to do other things like increase the size of the penis, use facial volume. So we're gonna use some of the fat if we have extra into those areas. Take a look. Morning guys, it's Dr. Emmer. We're doing a great case of primary male gladiator makeover. I'm really excited because this guy's athletic, he's fit. He has huge abs that are gonna be really defined after surgery. And we're just gonna kind of square off the chest a little bit and use the fat that we removed from his stomach, sides, and back to build up his chest. If we have enough, his buttock and his penis, I'm gonna show you guys penile rejuvenation today like we talk about frequently. It's gonna be great. It's going to have a little bit of size, and it's gonna help the stem cells that are in the fat are gonna help give the penis a little bit stronger erections and better orgasm. The male gladiator makeover entails not only removing fat, but tightening the skin and sculpting the muscle. And then we use that fat for other areas. Like today we're doing the chest, the buttock, and the penis if we have enough. So let me show you what he looks like and why he's gonna get such a good result. So as you guys can see, even from far away, you can actually see all the abs. And what's great is this little pocket of fat's gonna be removed and these abs will pop out more. So we'll have one, two, three, a six pack. And he's got little abs up top. From the side, not that much definition, but the serratus muscles will become more defined. He'll be much flatter at the bottom. All the back fat will be removed. You could see there. And if we have enough, we'll do a little bit to give him that soccer butt right at the top here. And we're gonna create those dimples that we always do in the back. He really doesn't have much fat. So the majority of the fat that we get really is gonna need to be used for the upper chest, because he really wants, if you look from the side, he doesn't have that rounded chest. So we really need to get that fat for the chest. So my focus is gonna be that. And then I'll show you what we do for the penis. So I'm really excited about today's results. It's gonna be really good. You guys stay tuned. We will show all components of the surgery and the penile fat grafting, which I think will be great. We'll get some amazing results today. And we'll show you, if you follow along on Instagram, you guys will see him over the next week as he's healing. So stay tuned for everything.
We're putting in the fluid now. This is gonna lift the tissue so that we can separate the fat from the muscle. It's also gonna allow all the fat cells to get hydrated so we can remove them safely and use them for grafting. We will see how much we have on the back. We may not have enough for his buttock if we don't get too much here. And we're going to do the lipo once the tumescent is in, and then we're going to determine how much fat we have. Now, since he doesn't have a lot of fat, this is actually really good to do vaser. Vaser is our ultrasonic lipo. If you come in close, you can hear the ultrasound is sound waves that are pushing apart the fat cell safely so we can use it for grafting. It's also creating some steam heat, so there's some additional skin tightening. This is gonna allow us to give him more of that contour. We wanna give him that hourglass look, that curved or that S shape. We wanna take this fat and see how much we can get to be able to get some for his buttock, his chest, and his penis. Now we're filming the Venus dimples, and since he's lean, it's gonna be much harder to do. We have to go very superficial in the fat layer. You can see, trying to get the cannula really up there and right on the skin to be able to remove any fat so we can create that dimple in the back and make him more of a soccer butt, more of a sexy butt, curved to his butt look.
So we have our fat grafting system here. We're using pure graft for today's patient. He doesn't have a lot of fat. So any little bit, we're gonna try to save, okay? So the first step is we're getting rid of all the excess fluid, all the impurities. Second step is we're gonna irrigate the fat. We're gonna put some irrigation that contains antibiotics in it, okay? Then we're gonna strain it again. We're gonna add our PRP to the mixture, and then we're gonna have our pure fat that's ready for transfer. Oh, 300 over.
Internal heating with the Renuvion flame. You guys saw the flame before. It's radio frequency helium plasma. We're using that now to tighten the back. This not only does some tightening in this area, but it also makes the fat layer more even. Remember, he doesn't have a lot, so you don't want it to be irregular when you go superficial. So we're using it to blend everything, to balance everything out. You can see the gas builds up. We have to pump the gas out, and then we go back to allow that tightening to occur. Thank you. putting the fluid in. First step, again, without a lot of fat, you really need to do a super wet technique where we put a lot of fluid in there to lift everything so we can get more definition without creating irregularities. Remember, a lot of people are getting irregularities lately due to poor liposuction cases, and often it's because they're trying to do high def on patients that are really skinny. And so this using the tumescent fluid, which has medication in it, will stop the bruising and make it easier for us to remove the fat. There we go. Yeah, Jason F. Snap is very good. His previous stories, his follow-ups are very good. His previous stories. Steven, I just gave you new selfies, and you could even use that the next day. And then I sent you an example of Alex L. We weren't filming videos at that time, but his before and after is amazing. I sent it to you the other day. Now we're doing the ultrasound portion. This is the vaser. This is using the sound waves to break apart the fat cells safely. We're hopefully gonna get enough fat to use for his chest, and we have a little bit saved from his back for his penis, so we're gonna be able to get some nice fat grafting. The good part here is we're really gonna be able to sculpt him with the vaser and get that six-pack look he's been looking for. He has amazing abs, so now we're gonna define them. Now we're doing the side of the chest, which many doctors don't do, again, to get the chest to be more sculpted. And we're using the vaser to really tighten all the angles here and get the upper back from the front part. So now we're doing the liposuction portion. This is a power-assisted lipo. And remember, we have an extra wet technique, so a lot of fluid's gonna come out. We're also doing the upper back from the front part, which is allowing us to get the lat muscle. Right now I'm working on the chest to contour the chest. He really wanted a little more definition on the sides, not as much underneath, but he also wanted a lot of tightness through his flanks and his back, which is what we're working on now. So we're sculpting the stomach now, and this is now gonna create his high def look. Remember, because he doesn't have a lot of fat, what's more important is how much we leave behind and what shaping we do, that's gonna give him the best results. We're already creating a little bit of that shaping in here. You guys will notice it very soon. Each area of the ab is being sculpted meticulously. Grabbing like the table, this works well. What? I mean, I'll just talk whenever you tell me.
Okay, let's go ahead and start right now. 3, 2, 1.
So now we're sculpting between the tendinous adhesions. Remember, he was athletic before, but because he couldn't see His muscle, we're gonna take the skin, remove the fat between the muscle, and get the skin to tighten down. Look at that little pieces coming out. All those little pieces are gonna start to form that adhesion. Take a look. You can see it already making shape right there. Final touches. We are looking at his six pack already, take a look. But what do we want to do? We want to make it even better. So we are going to tighten the area now, which is what we're doing with our Renuvion internal heating radio frequency plasma. You guys can actually see the flame, you could hear it. The crazy thing is, look at how sculpted he is already without any of the tightening, because he already had a really natural tight build. So what does that go to show? That the thinner you are, the more athletic you are before we do gladiator lipo, the more I'm gonna be able to get you tightened and sculpted. You wanna be in shape. We don't wanna take fat and turn it into a ninja turtle. We want it to look natural and athletic, which is what he's got. You can see his breathing occurring partially right now. You see the up and down. That's allowing us to determine that it's gonna look really natural when he is breathing on his own. We are focusing on this lower region and this tendon adhesion at the bottom, because this is the area where he had a little problem, pouch of fat. And we really just want to get this super sculpted. So we are...
No, guys, it's a sculpting procedure, not a weight loss procedure.
No, if you want weight loss, there are things we can do. Yeah, we can do peptide therapy, which I'm on. You guys can see... My best friend did that with his buttock. He lost over 200 pounds, so he did buttock fat grafting, whatever we had, and then he did an implant. You guys can hear how strong that is. So we're injecting fat now into the chest. To the upper portion mainly, because that's really what concerns him. He wants a more rounded look. And this is gonna help give him more of that gladiator chest and that lift to the chest and give him some more bulk that he was looking for. Take that out real quick. That's one. Let's do two and then I'll go to the other side. Two. Let's go over there. No, it's still not going. Okay.
whitish tissue that we see here is a small piece of glandular or breast tissue. Same kind that women have, except for men it's much smaller. And what it does is it makes the nipple and the areola stick out a little too much. And when we remove it, the chest appears more chiseled and leaner and not as pointy. It's just a more masculine look. So it's a combination of removing excess fat and excess glandular tissue. So now you can see the edge of his pectoralis muscle right here. What kind of dressing?
Usually stand with this one. Usually perfect. Good call.
That's fine.
Check it out. Yeah.